I will be a veterinarian.
I will advocate for women to live their healthiest lives.
I will change the stigma against mental health.
I will not be defined by others' expectations.
I will be a mathematician at NASA.
I will create safe spaces for all identities.
I will empower the next generation.
There is a wildlife veterinarian who, you know, travels the world with Animal Planet, and he just does all these crazy things, and I never thought that that was possible. And now that I'm seeing it, I'm like, okay, this could be a job that I can do because someone's doing it already. I want to show people that you don't have to look a certain way or be a certain type of person to do it. You can just do it if you want to. Like, STEM is for everybody. As long as you work hard, like, you can accomplish whatever you want.
I want to be an OBGYN, and I'm looking into maternal fetal medicine. I really want to work with low-income women, and specifically Latina and African-American populations. That's mainly the patient population I want to help because that is my population, that's my community. I think it's really important to give back to where you come from and to advocate for your community as well. I am Latina-American. I grew up in Boston, and so I want to work in Boston, and I want to help the same community that raised me.
Being in a minority in STEM, it makes me feel accomplished because my ancestors weren't able to do these type of things. They weren't able to even study STEM. They weren't even able to go to school. So being able to be here and be able to do this and be able to do something I love and be able to potentially change the world, I realized like how important it is to be a Black woman in the science fields and like how unrepresented we are and how like I represent something for someone, for another little Black girl looking at me and like, oh, I can do this as well because she looks like me and she's doing that.
I'm part of the Society of Women Engineers. Going to SWE was just a way for me to like relax, be around my own peers, have a support system telling me I'm good enough. One of my biggest fears was sometimes I was scared that, oh, my hijab might hold me back. And it honestly hasn't. If anything, it's made me more aware of who I am. Knowing that every time I get up in the morning, I am representing my faith, my people. It's okay to just be yourself and to own who you are. Because at the end of the day, it's your value of yourself and your opinion of yourself that matters.
To be a woman in STEM, you have to be thick-skinned, in my opinion, because you're probably going to be one of the only women in the room. We've done so much in the way of like the hashtag MeToo movement, just integrating women into finding the black hole and being doctors as opposed to just being nurses. Being a woman in STEM just shows how much drive every person that is in that field has, because you have to overcome so many obstacles in order to make it, but so many people are able to make it, which just shows how strong each and every one of us is.
I want to make more awareness to diversity in the STEM field, particularly more awareness about like LGBT individuals in the STEM field. Outside of STEM, I found it important to find safe spaces. Personally, I identify as bisexual, and like coming to terms with that identity really evolved through my involvement in the Rainbow Center. My goal one day is to hopefully be in a certain position of power where I can be out about my identities, and so that young girls like me, when they're growing up, they can see me and other people like me and be like, yeah, I can make it too.
Since I was a little kid, I think I knew that I wanted to make some type of impact on the world. I realized that that is a really hard mission to have. So making impacts on just people in general or just anyone that I interact with is something that I want to do. I'm heavily involved in Engineering Ambassadors here on campus. We do outreach through K-12 students to get them to have an insight into the STEM world. Just having us women or just underrepresented students in general go out and target these students gets them to have a role model. I had a little girl come up to me and say, one day I want to be just like you. And comments like that just make you want to do STEM even more and want to go out and find these students to get them to pursue STEM.
I want the future of STEM to be colorful. I want people to be able to see trans people to be able to see people of color, people to be able to see women and men and not feel like this is only a men's field.
I want the future of STEM to be empowering. I want us to be proud of all women who are pursuing STEM, because together as a unit, as a family, we can change the world.
I am a woman in STEM.
I am a woman in STEM. I am a woman in STEM.
I am a woman in STEM.
I am a woman in STEM.
We are women!